In terms of selling, you need one more day.
Understood. All right, Piyush, thanks for taking us through all of that. It is all about Karnataka elections. In fact, let's bring in Sunil Subramaniam, CEO at Sundaram Mutual Funds as well. Good afternoon, Sunil. You know, we gained 100 points. We've given up 100 points. We're completely flattered with just an hour to go for the market to close. The latest trigger, of course, the sharp sell-off we saw in the afternoon was on the back of these reports that the Congress and the JDS may finally form the government in Karnataka. That wasn't the idea that we were working through the course of the day. What do you think is a most weighing on market participants' mind at the moment? Do you think that participants are looking at whether or not the BJP actually finally forms government, or do you think it's more important that they emerge the single largest party? Or what really do you think we should be reading as the key cues here?
See, for the moves today, I think the euphoria was the fact that the BJP might form the government, and the sell-off was because the BJP is not going to form the government. But I think this is a very knee-jerk reaction for the day. Because if you go dwell deep down, what the market, Karnataka state is not going to determine India's GDP or any direction. So the market was actually positive because of two factors, right? And I was calling this the CQ, two CQ factors, right? First is that the BJP's confidence quotient, right, for the 2019 election would have got a strong boost from, because I think the swing from last assembly to this is almost 68 to 70 seats plus for the BJP. So that's a confidence boost for the BJP. That is one thing the market had factored in. Second is the continuity quotient, right? For the market, they want continuity in the policy at the central government level, right? Which again is a factor of what is the likelihood of the parliamentary election going the BJP way. And I think when the market opens tomorrow and looks at these results, and they'll realize that in when central issues are at play, if BJP in a state level is able to get this swing, in a central thing, probably Karnataka is going to be in BJP's bag, right? So I would say that this is actually a good result. Forget about the fact they actually formed the government in Karnataka or not. It indicates that in the south of India, BJP has got a state where they have made a strong inroads. I still don't have the vote share percentages, right, but I'm sure even that would show that. So I think continuity for the markets, confidence for the BJP, I think both are there in terms of this result and would be a favorable thing from a market outlook perspective, from my perspective.
There's some live visuals there on your screen of Karnataka. The incumbent Chief Minister Siddaramaiah, we don't know whether he will stay on or not. The speculation, of course, rising that it could be a tie-up between BJP and... It's official now. Congress-JDS tie-up has been confirmed, not giving any details as to who the Chief Minister candidate will be if they, indeed they do cross the halfway mark and get to that magic figure of beyond 113. But nonetheless, Congress, they're confirming that JDS and the party have joined hands. They will be meeting with the governor at 4 p.m., by which time the trends should be clear and you should have more winners on the screen as far as the confirmed results go. The BJP is still the single largest party, but the Congress-JDS combined may in fact have the possibility of forming the government over here. There are two more seats that will be up for grabs when the election for that happens later this month. But as of now, the way things stand, it is the Congress-JDS tie-up that is confirmed, may have the winning majority combined and could pip BJP to the post of Chief Minister in Karnataka. Murli, what a day we've had.
Absolutely.
As far as the swings,
I mean,
on today's market.
If
goes,
there is a volatility index, then you can you could have plotted it. It would have gone up like this, come down, and that's what the charts are reflecting. But Deepanshu, the issue again, you know, as we have been pointing out since morning, is that it's the JDS combined. Devegowda, Kumaraswamy, they know the game very well. They are masters at this. They will go all out to make sure that BJP is kept out. That's how they are looking at. Because for BJP, it's a victory. But as far as Karnataka is concerned, you know, what Karnataka has to look at is a stable government. Well, that is going to be the challenge. Because the numbers, when they come very clearly, will they suggest a hung parliament? Now, that is where the challenge is. Suppose, you know, you get a clear 112, that's a different story. But the clear 112 might be slightly difficult to get. So that's what we need to wait and watch. But who the Chief Minister candidate from the Congress JDS combined, that's going to be a bigger challenge. That will drag on. It may not get resolved in a day or two. It's going to be longer than what we anticipated.
Right. Sunil, you were saying just before those comments came in that regardless of the result and regardless of whether BJP forms a government or not, they have clearly made inroads, and it's a sharp swing from where they were last time around. There are many more state elections lined up. There are, of course, general elections 1 year down the line. X of today's verdict, of course, how should the street be viewing this development? And more importantly, what could be the reform agenda? What could be the economic agenda in the last year of this government?
So there are three, four factors at play here. So I think the first thing is that the market after today's volatility will, I think, respect the fact that the BJP has made a strong inroad into a non-North bastion. I think that's one takeaway. Second aspect of it is that I think that the case for advancing of the general elections is quite much strengthened now, because one thing the BJP is realizing that pure local level factors, when they come in, the chance for them to get clear majorities is getting impaired. So I think if you look at the three states, BJP is in power. Anti-incumbency will be at play. So from that perspective, the BJP will probably take a serious look. I think the Election Commission has already given a go-ahead to the government to advance the elections. The other machinery is also in place. So if that happens, then market will take that very positively, because when in these states the anti-incumbency factor is countered by the central who should come to power, I would say that
this is the only space that's not participated in the market that has hit all-time highs and is near all-time highs. Is there a case for sectoral churn happening in pharma? Is there a case for domestic business to drive these names forward, or do you still see some concerns, still some headwinds for the sector ahead?
We still see some headwinds for this sector arising from two points. See, the two stories which are driving, right? Money is at a premium, right? So it goes to, like, water finds its higher level, money finds. The two stories today driving thing are Indian infrastructure play with consumption and global economic recovery, right? So in a global economic recovery, right, pharma is not something which correlates with well-being of global economy, right? It's a negative story, you know. So the point is that if you look at it from the fact that domestically there's price control, the government wants to make healthcare cheaper. Domestic, worldwide, if you see Trump also, he is looking at boosting the profits of American multinational firms. He's trying to get the money back in there. He's reduced taxation. Second, he's winding down Obama healthcare. Whatever all Obama's programs he wants to wind down. So if you look at the headwinds in terms of that factor, right, it's not looking good for pharma. There are pockets within pharma which are looking good, which are like Indian, healthcare, right? Not as in pharma, but hospitals and healthcare. So there are pockets which are looking good. But overall, as a sector, I would say that if you want to play rupee depreciation, pharma is one, but IT is a better play. If you want to play recovery, again, IT exports are a better play than pharma. So in every aspect where pharma will drive value, there is a better sector available. So in terms of the choice of where to put the money, though the valuations are looking attractive, there are other things which can give a bigger bump up. So I think it's a relative play. So pharma has to wait for a little more time while the other sectors play out their gains, and then the money will flow into pharma.
So tie it in for us. What's your broader call on the markets going forward from here, and which sectors will have the traction?
Okay, so if you look at it from a portfolio perspective, right, I think till this election happened, we were at about 60% defensives, 40% aggressives, if I use the opposite word to that. So when I call, what do I today label in defensives? Consumption, rural transformation, rural infrastructure, rural consumption, and IT. Right, these were the defensive sectors, and the aggressive sectors were essentially corporate banks, infrastructure, EPC contractors, capital goods suppliers, steel, cement, that pack, right? But I think today's election result has made a small shift. Today, like I was mentioning earlier, the BJP's massive surge in votes and everything means that there's a greater confidence around the election. So I think the infrastructure play will now get a reassessment. So the allocation towards the longer end of the curve, right, would tend to go up. So I think the real value creation is going to happen in infrastructure and things which feed into infrastructure like capital goods, steel, cement. So that's our broader call in the market.
Fair point, Sunil. Thanks so much for coming in and running us through your reading of the markets and the political dynamics of it as well. Just about 20 minutes to go to close. The markets seem to have stabilized for now at around that 10,800 mark. We'll come back, talk some of these buzzing stocks with Rajesh Satpute as well, get a couple of his trading ideas as well. Shrikant Shetty from Motilal Oswal will join in too and analyze some of the other stocks that are in focus on the back of earnings. Back in 2 minutes.